गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर सचिन सर. ओके, सो फार वी हैव डन मेनी क्लासेस इन द वीडियोस. वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस सेपरेट कॉन्सेप्ट्स, कन्वेंशंस रिगार्डिंग द इंट्रोडक्शंस ऑफ एक्सपेंडिचर्स एंड ऑल. टिल नाउ वी हैवंट डिस्कस्ड द एंटायर कोर्स ऑफ योर सेकेंड ईयर अकाउंटिंग और अकाउंटेंसी वॉल्यूम टू. सो आई हैव मेड ए नोट रिगार्डिंग द कोर्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर throughout this year, or you can also say this accounting year, as we are the acquainted with the accounting concepts and the assessment years and all. So this is what the second year accounting course we are going to discuss. Okay, so please look carefully. Your accounting second year course is total comprises of 4 units. Okay, your total second year accounting course comprises of 4 units. The first unit comprises of some chapters. As you can see here, I have made a note regarding that. The first chapter is Introduction to Expenditure and its Types. And we have made videos and also I have explained very well regarding this Introduction to Expenditure and all. And also the notes are sent to you. I hope you have prepared the notes. The second chapter comes about final account, that is into two parts. Final account is without adjustment, and the second part of the final account is final account with adjustment. So we will be discussing about the financial statements, and I've also made videos about financial statements, that how many type of financial statements are there, how do you prepare those financial statements, how do you post the entries, how do you pass the closing entries, how do you make the closure of the financial statements and all. So if you have any doubt regarding this preparation of financial statements, you can go through the videos and you can see the specimen or format for preparation of financial statements. So moving ahead, the introduction to expenditure is finished. We have made videos and discussed about the preparation of financial statements, the pro forma in detail. So next part we will be discussing about final account. Okay, that is without adjustment. So before going to final account without adjustment, let us have a look properly over the courses that we are going to cover in the second year. Okay, so there are the two parts of final account, that is without adjustment and with adjustment. And the another chapter, or the last chapter of the first unit is financial statements of not-for-profit organization, that you can also call as non-trading organization or non-profit making organization. Why such organization is called as not-for-profit, non-trading or non-profit making organization is a very good topic, and we shall discuss the arguments regarding these three points, and we will make a proper distinction between these three things, that is not-for-profit or non-trading or non-profit making organization. Well, we will be coming to this chapter. Okay, so moving on to our another unit, that is unit 2. Again, unit 2 comprises of 2 chapters. The first chapter is single entry system, or this chapter is also known as accounts from incomplete records. As you know students, we have studied about double entry system, and why double entry system was evolved you also know, because certain problems were faced by the developer called bookkeeper called Luca Pacioli. So double entry system was evolved because every business transaction has two aspects or two effects or two sides, because a transaction cannot be recorded having a single aspect, because minimum two aspects or two parties are involved in a business transaction. So it will be very unique or different to see how the single entry system or accounts from incomplete records are made, or what this chapter is speaking all about. So since it is single entry system, it is also known as accounts from incomplete records. Another chapter coming under unit 2 is depreciation, provisions and reserves. You know about depreciation. What depreciation is? It is the reduction in the book value of a fixed asset due to use and passage of time. And provision and reserves is a new topic, but these things comes by the virtue of contingent liability, or these are the contingent liability that exists because of the convention of conservatism. So we shall discuss in detail all those things when we'll be going into this chapter. Okay, so this is the two chapters that we are going to discuss under unit 2. Moving on, third unit is accounting for partnership. Okay, so you have discussed and you have studied the chapter called partnership in your two subjects, that is business mathematics and statistics, and business studies and management. So it's time we should study the chapter called partnership under accounting. It will be very easier for you to understand this chapter because you have studied already in two subjects, that is the theory part in BSM and the problem part in BMS. So I think it will be very helpful and very easier for you to understand this chapter, since this chapter you have studied twice in two different proforma, and now we'll be studying the same thing but in accounting, how we'll record transactions relating to partnership, we'll see. So partnership is the total unit that covers the unit 3, but it is having some chapters under it. That is the first chapter that I made points like A, B and C. So you can say it as a chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. So under third unit, partnership is the total coverage of the unit, means you, under unit 3 you will be reading all about partnership. The first chapter under partnership is capital or final accounts of the partners. That means how you will prepare the capital accounts or the final accounts of the partners, how they take interest, how interest is charged on them, how profit or losses are shared between those partners working in an organization, that we'll see under this chapter. Okay, second chapter is reconstitution of firm. Reconstitution is the term comes when there is any admission, death or retirement of a partner. That is why I have written here in the bracket. Reconstitution totally speaks about a situation where a partner is admitted or it suffers from death or he is retired. So in these cases the firm is reconstituted. So that is why the chapter is named as reconstitution of firm. Okay, but we have only this part in our course that we'll be discussing under the third chapter of partnership under unit 3, that is admission of a new partner. Death and retirement is not in our second year course. So we will be discussing the last chapter in unit 3, that is admission of a new partner. Okay, moving on to our next unit, that is unit 4. Unit 4 is totally all about the company. Again, you know that you have studied about the company accounts in your BSM and also in your mathematics in first year. Okay, where you will be studying regarding the shares, stocks, memorandum of association, article of association, foundation of a company, types of company, features of company. Likewise partnership, it will be very easier for you to understand company too, because this is also a chapter or a unit that you have covered already in the first year in two different subjects. Okay, so these two units are bigger, but it will be very easier for you to understand since you have studied it in first year and also in two subjects. So the unit fourth is totally about the company accounts, but it has again two chapters that I have written as A and B. These two chapters are first company accounts, where we'll be reading accounting for share capital, where we'll be making records for different type of shares, how shares are made, how shares are distributed, how shares are issued by a company, how share capital is, share capital structure is made. All those details we'll be discussing about in this chapter, accounting for share capital. And the last chapter of the last unit is accounting for debentures under company accounts. Okay, so you have also studied about debentures. Debentures, meaning, types, difference between shares and debentures. So under the last unit, that is fourth unit, we'll be discussing about the company accounts. The first chapter is about accounting for share capital. The second chapter is for accounting for debentures. So this is what the total second year course is of yours, that is unit 1. We have discussed already this introduction to expenditure and its types. Next we'll be going to discuss about the final account. You can make a note of the units and its chapters for which I made this video. Okay, if some of the students are not having the books of the second year accounting books, so they can make the note of these units in detail. But as per the discussion of the units, under first unit we have discussed the introduction of expenditure, and under final account I have told in the interpretation process that the last process of a business organization or the last function of a business organization, where it is records and transactions are made in final account. That final account where some financial statements are prepared. How many type of financial statements are prepared? There are three types of financial statements, that is trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. I have also made videos regarding the preparation of trading account, preparation of profit and loss account, also preparation of balance sheet. So it should be very clear about the preparation of financial statements or the meaning of financial statements before going to this chapter. Okay, so this is very easier chapter because it is not having any adjustment. As you can see, final account is divided into two parts. That is, first part is without adjustment, second part is with adjustment. So it will be very easy to discuss the final account without adjustment. That means you will not be having any adjustment entries. You will be having only those entries in the trial balance that you call as closing entries, and you have to pass it only into trading or profit and loss account or balance sheet. As you know, we have seen in the earlier videos that trading account is closed, as a result gross profit or gross loss, the same gross profit or gross loss is transferred to second financial statement, that is called profit and loss account, as brought down, where again you compare the indirect incomes and indirect expense and you get the result as net profit or net loss, and that net profit or net loss is transferred to your balance sheet under the liability side, where under the head fixed liability you are having a most important item that is called as capital account. There you make necessary adjustments of net profit or net loss. I have also discussed it in detail in the preparation of financial statement part 2 video. Okay, so now we shall go or proceed with final account without adjustment. So we will start with trading account. Please have a proper look and see the question as we are discussing now. Okay, so students, here we go. We will be discussing about the final account without adjustment. Under this chapter we will be discussing about trading account, how we will prepare trading account. So this is the question. The question is, question speaks about, from the following particulars extracted from the accounting books of Messrs. Rajiv and Sons for the year ending 31st March 2009. Prepare the trading account, also give closing entries. So students, I have told you how to prepare trading account. We will be doing the same now. Okay, but there is nothing to get confusion about closing entries. As you know, the transactions or the items that are existing in your trial balance, and when you post it into trading account and profit and loss account and balance sheet, those postings are only called as, or those transfer entries are only called as the closing entries. So don't get confused with this term, the closing entries. Okay, when we're getting adjustments, that will be called as adjustment entries. But this is a chapter without adjustment. So here you will be getting only closing entry. That means when you post this item to your respective financial statement, that is your trading account or profit and loss account or finances or balance sheet, those items or those posted items are only called as the closing entries. Okay, so let us see. We will distinguish here the debit, what are the direct expenses and direct income, because as you know, trading account is prepared for a factory or production unit, where the expenses are called as direct nature or direct expenses, and the incomes are called of direct nature, that is direct income. Okay, so let us see and identify the direct expense and direct income that will be posted in the trading account. Okay, so the first is opening stock. So generally, opening stock is taken to the debit side of trading account. It would, for a better presentation, I have made the solution of this trading account in my book. Okay, no need to worry about it. I will make a proper explanation how these items are posted. Okay, just look carefully. First is opening stock. As we have discussed in this specimen, opening stock is posted to the debit side of trading account. The amount is 1000. See, I posted the opening stock on the debit side of trading account. And it is written as trading account for the year ended 31st March 2009. This is debit side, this is credit side. And since it is prepared on the single date or the at the end of an accounting year, it does not have any date column. Same goes with the profit and loss account also, as we have discussed in our specimen videos. Okay, there will not be any date column either on the debit side or either on the credit side. And not the folio columns too. You will be having only particulars and amount column on each of the debit side and credit side. Okay, so the first item is opening stock that we have posted in the debit side of trading account. That is 1000. Okay, then next is purchases. Always look forward whether the purchases is having returns or not, and also the items like sales is having return or not. Here the items of purchases and sales both are having returns. Okay, the thing you can do is to the returns is, it can be treated in two ways. That means when you post purchases, you can deduct these returns, or you can post this purchase return on the opposite side of purchases. Same goes with sales also. if you post the sales, you can deduct the returns from the sales, or you can post the sales return on the opposite sides of sales account, as we've discussed in our format. Okay. So purchases are supposed to be the direct expenses. It will go to the debit side of trading account. So purchases is 9750. I've written here purchases 9750 in the inner column, because I've deducted here returns, and the returns is about 250 rupees that I've made deduction from purchases. So the purchases I've written in the inner column 9750, and I've made a deduction of the returns, that is 250 rupees. And here the final or the net amount of purchases I've posted in the outer column or the external column, that is 9500. Okay. The next item is sales, and it is also the item that is having the returns. So students, what is sales? Sales is a income. What kind of income? It is a direct income. How much is the sales? 12,500. I posted it on the credit side of trading account, and since it is having returns, I posted it in the inner column, that is 12,500. So let's see what is the amount of returns. Sales return is 125. So I have made the returns from the sales itself, and the final amount or the net amount of sales after deduction of 125 rupees is posted to the external column of trading account, that is 12,375. You can also reach it. Okay. Then there is factory rent. As we have known, trading account is prepared for factory or production unit. Okay. So in factory or production unit, whatever the expenses are made are supposed to be the direct expenses. So factory rent is taken to be the direct expenses. So similarly, I posted it on the debit side of trading account, that is 50 rupees. Then wages. Wages are paid to the workers, and workers work in the factory or production unit. So wages can be taken as the direct expenses. Okay, so I have written here two wages, 750 rupees. Next item is octroi. So octroi is a kind of transport charges that happens with the purchases. When you purchase goods, okay, at that time you make it a separate different type of transport charges, out of which octroi is a type of duty charged on the commodities or services. Okay, so octroi is 250 rupees. Again, it is taken to be the direct expenses and posted on the debit side of trading account, that is 250 rupees. Moving on to another item, that is carriage inward. Students, I have discussed about carriages. Carriages are of two types, that is carriage inward and carriage outward. So carriage inward is the expenses that is made on the purchases, but carriage outward are the expenses that are made on the sales. So here, if carriage inward is there, that means it's supposed to be the direct expenses, or the expenses that are made on purchases, or the even the expenses that are made before production activity starts. So carriage inward happens to be the direct expenses, that is of 100 rupees, will be posted to the debit side of trading account. Okay, debit side of trading account, I put the carriages. You can write carriages only, because since it comes under trading account debit side, no need to mention that inward. Even if you can mention that two carriages inward. If you don't mention also, this means carriage inward only. So it is 100 rupees. Okay. Then there is factory lighting. So again, the term factory is there. That means it is the expenses of the trading account, or it is direct expenses. Again, it is to be posted to the debit side of trading account. So let's see how much is the factory lighting. It is 25 rupees. And again, it is posted to the debit side of trading account. That is 25 rupees. Moving on to the next item, office salaries. See, office is also another business unit that is working for the administration, or which having a financial statement called profit and loss account. When we have made distinction between these financial statements, I have told you that trading account is prepared for the production of factory unit, and the profit and loss account is the second financial statement that is made for office or administrative purposes. So any expenses regarding the office are taken to be the indirect expenses, and indirect expenses, as you know, are posted to the profit and loss account. Okay, so office salaries are the indirect expenses that will be gone, or that will be posted to the debit side of profit and loss account. In other way also, if you see office salaries, so salaries are paid to whom? The employees. Where does the employees work? In the factory? No, the salaries are given to the employees because they work in the office. That is why given here office. So salaries are paid to the employees, they work in the office. So that is why office salaries are taken to be the indirect expenses, and it will not be posted in your trading account. Okay. Moving on to the next and the last item of trading account, that is general expenses. Again, the expenses is named as general expenses. Do you know why? because sometimes it may be possible that some expenses may be incurred by a business organization, but there may not be any accounting, there may not be any record. So there are some expenses that are made, but there is no accountability for recording of those expenses. But somehow, if at any point of time, if you remember that there are some expenses that are made in the past, but you haven't made any record regarding that and you don't know what that expense are all about. So in that case, these expenses are giving the name as general expense, or you can name it as miscellaneous expenses, or you can name it as a sundry expenses. So expenses having these three names like general, sundry expenses, miscellaneous expenses, these expenses are taken to be indirect expenses, because the expenses which are primary in nature or the expenses which are directly made or related to the goods or production unit are taken to be the direct expenses. And if you don't know the expenses are made for what purpose, since the purpose is unknown, we cannot take those expenses to be the direct expenses. Therefore, we will take the expenses of general or miscellaneous or sundry nature as a indirect expenses, since the purpose is not yet known. Okay, so general expenses are supposed to be the also indirect expenses or made for office purposes. We will take these expenses to the profit and loss account, and being an indirect expense, it will not be posted in trading account. See, I have not posted it. Okay. So this is all about your trading account. All the items are posted. So let us recheck. Opening stock is posted. Purchases is posted with returns. The final amount is also put. Then there is sales. It is posted in the trading account credit side in the inner column. There is returns to sales, and also it is deducted from the sales, and final amount is put on the outer column, that is 12,675. Then there is factory rent, I have posted on the debit side of trading account. Then there is wages, it is also posted, 750 rupees. Octroi, 250 rupees, posted on the debit side, 250 rupees. Then factory lighting is also 25 rupees, posted on the debit side of trading account. But as I've discussed, office salaries and general expenses are supposed to be the indirect expenses. So these two expenses will not be taken to trading account. Okay. And the last item that is left over in this question is closing stock on 31st March 2009 was 1750. Students, as I've discussed, opening stock is a stock that relates to the closing stock of last year. And since it is brought down in this year, it is called as opening stock. And closing stock is opposite to opening stock, it will be posted on the opposite side of opening stock. Okay, because this stock will be again taken to be as the opening stock of your next year or next financial year. Okay, so closing stock amounted to 1750. Why it is named as closing stock, you can see, because the stock was calculated or valued on this date, that is 31st March 2009. That is taken to be the end or the last day of accounting year. So on the last day or the end day, the stock is valued, the name is closing stock. So closing stock will be posted on the opposite side of opening stock. See, I have also made a posting of closing stock. So closing stock is posted on the credit side of trading account. As I have told, this is the closing balance of the stock. It should be posted by giving a sufficient gap in the credit side of trading account. There is no reason, just it is made as a proper allocation, nothing else. Okay. So now, we have to close the ledger account and we have to put the totals. So we have to make the total of the debit side and the total of the credit side, and we have to put the highest total on both the sides. As you know, matching concept says the highest total is put on both the sides because we can make a proper difference where does the deficit amount lies. So I have also made the total of this trading account. As you can see, the items here, items are much but the amounts are very lesser. Okay, the items are much but the amounts are very lesser compared to credit side of trading account. See, there are only two items, but the items totaling, as you can see, are much more than the debit side of trading account. So here there are more items but the lesser amount, and here there are two items but having higher amount. So we can say the highest total is of the credit side, or the credit side is more than the debit side. So the total of credit side is taken to be as the highest total, and we'll put on both the sides. So I've taken the credit side total, that comes 14,125. Okay, so I put this total on both the sides because, as we know, as I've told now, the total of the credit side is more than the debit side. As you can see here, it's very simple question and very small question where you can see and calculate that the total of the credit is more than the debit side. Okay, So the credit side total is put on both the sides because it is the highest total. And to avoid any confusion or any dilemma, we have also made the total of the debit side. Okay, we have also made the debit of the total side that I have written on the end. That comes about 11,675 rupees. Okay, take a proper look. This is the total of the credit side. That is 14,125. That is the highest total. So I put it on the both the sides. And to avoid any confusion or any type of misappropriations, I have also made the total of the debit side that I put at the bottom. This is not supposed to put here, but I have put here just to make you clear that the total of the debit side is much lesser than the credit side. So this is just to avoid any confusion and misappropriation. There is no requirement to put this total here, but I have made this total to make you clear. So this total of the debit side comes of 11,605 rupees. So it is clear that the debit side is lesser than the credit side. Okay, or the credit side is more than the debit side. So now the deficit amount is put on the deficit side, and that deficit here is called as gross profit because the credit side is the income side, debit side is the expense side. So the direct income is more than the direct expenses. Therefore, the result is profit. And since the direct income is more than the direct expense, under trading account or under the production unit, the name is given as gross profit. So I have written as gross profit carried down. And when you subtract these two, you get 2450. So this is your answer of trading account. Let us check whether the answer is correct or not. See, the answer is 2450. So we have made it correctly. You can also have a recheck by watching this video. This is the highest total that comes in the credit side and we put in both the sides. And this is the total of the debit side, that is 11,605. And when you subtract these two, that is 14,125 rupees minus 11,605 rupees, the amount comes to 2,450. So this is the gross profit of this question and the answer is correct. Okay, so in the next video, we shall be discussing about the preparation of profit and loss account. If you have any doubt regarding the preparation of trading account or any posting of the items on the debit or either in the credit side or any exclusion of the items like that should go to the profit and loss account, you can ask me without any hesitation. I would love to help you and clear your doubts. Okay, thank you.